Hello, my name is Andrew Diamond. I'm the lead developer at APTrust, and I'm going to talk to you today about running jobs and workflows in Dart. Dart is the digital archivist's resource tool, and it lets you bag up files and send them across the network to an S3 bucket or an SFTP server. From there, they can be picked up by a preservation archive or anyone else who needs to process them. So a job is basically packaging up a set of files in Bagit format. You can drag in a folder or multiple folders. Those contain the materials that you want to be bagged. This one happens to contain four directories and 19 files, about 6 megabytes of materials. I am going to say I want to package these files in Bagit format. I'm going to bag them up according to the APTrust Bagit profile. This one I'm choosing with default values has some of our commonly used tag values already pre-filled. For example, in most bags, you have to provide a value for the source organization tag in the bagit.txt file. Typically, that won't change from one bag to the next. So in your Bagit profile, you can define a default value for source organization and other tags that tend to stay the same from bag to bag. Then you won't have to define them in each bag that you make. And we'll get to Bagit profiles and customizing Bagit profiles in another video. APTrust bags have to be submitted in tar format, so that's pre-selected. And I'll give this bag a name. Call it demo bag. When Dart bags it up, it will show up in this file right here, as we'll see in just a moment. So I've chosen my packaging format. I have to fill in some tag values. I'll give this a description. And a title. These are required by the APTrust Bagit profile, and they'll go into the aptrustinfo.txt file. There's also the baginfo.txt file, which is standard in pretty much every Bagit profile. I'm not going to fill in anything here because none of these values are required. If I show all tags, it shows me that some of these are already filled in by default, like access, storage option. These grayed out ones, like bagging date and whatnot, will be filled out by Dart when it creates the bag. Typically, you don't need to show all of those fields, just the ones that you may need to fill in. After filling in tags, I say I want to upload this bag to our APTrust staging server, which is an S3 bucket in AWS, and I'm going to send a copy to a local S3 service, which I use for testing. If I wanted to, I could check all of these, and it will upload the bag to all of those locations after it creates it. For now, I just want to send to these two. I click Next, and I get a review of this job I'm about to run. It gives me the package name, Bagit profile, what I'm bagging up, where it's going to put this bag, and where it's going to put it on my local system, and where it's going to send it. So if I click Run, it creates the bag, it validates it, it uploads it to these two services. The output path is now a link, so if I click on that, it actually shows me where that bag is on my local hard drive. Now, if I want to repeat this workflow, bagging according to our APTrust profile and uploading to these two services, after my job has run successfully, I can click Create Workflow. I give this a name, and description is optional. It tells me that this workflow includes a packaging step in Bagit format using the APTrust Bagit profile, and it includes uploading to the staging server and our local S3. I click Save, and it saved our October demo workflow right here. Now, I want to run a whole bunch of directories through that workflow, bag them all up, and send them to those two servers. So I click Run Batch and choose a workflow, my October demo workflow, and choose a CSV file that contains information about the batch. A CSV file is basically just an Excel spreadsheet saved in text format. And I want to run this test batch. And just to give you an idea of what this test batch file looks like, contains just a few columns. The name of the bag that will be created, I guess there are 20 of them here. The root directory that contains all the files that will go into that bag. And then tag values for the title tag for each bag in the aptrust.info file. A description and some other tags that are required, such as access level. That's APTrust specific. And then we have a few other tag values filled in here for each bag. For now, I'm actually going to delete a few of these because they're going to take a long time to run. So I'm going to choose that test batch. I think I left about 10 jobs in there. Now it's going to run the October demo workflow over every job defined in that test batch file. So you see it goes through the packaging step, validation step, and the two upload steps for each bag. And as it completes each line of the file, it lists them under the results down here at the bottom with a green check mark to indicate that the job completed successfully. If one of the jobs in your workflow fails, Dart will print a red X next to it down here so that you know it failed, and it will continue and process the other jobs. The most common reason for these jobs to fail is either a network error on upload, in which case you can retry the job, or Dart is asked to package up some files that it doesn't have access to. If you're missing read access to files in a directory that you're going to bag up, Dart can't read them, and you get an error. Anyway, that is it for jobs and workflows. I'll get into Bagit profiles and some other features of Dart in future videos. Thanks for watching.